exposed. Exposed. Exposed.
You're exposed. You're exposed. You are exposed. 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 You are exposed, sir. I'm gonna expose you. Expose you. Oh my god, expose you.
Before we get into the tea, I just want to take a moment to expose a company. NordVPN. Nord is a VPN service that helps keep you safe while browsing online. With Nord, all of your internet data stays safe behind a wall of protection. This really comes in handy when you're using public Wi-Fi networks. Have you ever been at school or maybe in a cafe working on your laptop and connected to their free Wi-Fi network? If you aren't using a VPN, you're leaving your connection open to possible hackers who might be trying to see your passwords or banking information saved on your computer. If you have a VPN turned on though, it's kind of like a locked door with all your personal information on the inside and the hackers stuck on the outside. The nice thing about Nord is even though you're adding this extra layer of protection over your internet, it doesn't sacrifice your internet speed at all. They provide you with an ultra-fast connection and great security. My absolute favorite thing about Nord has to be all the options it opens me up to on Netflix and other streaming services. Nord has over 5,400 servers in 59 different countries, which means you're able to access movies and shows from all over the world. If NordVPN sounds like something you'd be interested in, right now you can get a huge discount on a 2-year plan. All you gotta do is go to nordvpn.com/tspill to get the offer, and when you use code tspill checking out, you're gonna get an additional month for free. That's nordvpn.com/tspill, and don't forget to use code tspill when checking out. The great thing is, NordVPN has a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you can try it out risk-free. Thank you, NordVPN, for sponsoring this video, and let's get into the tea. So it hasn't even been 24 hours, and already so much stuff has gone down between Trisha Paytas, Shane Dawson, and Jeffree Star. If you're not caught up with the cold tea, I'll leave a link down below for my video about how this whole mess started. Anyways, after Trisha posted her video that kicked everything off, and after her and Jeffree went back and forth a bit on Twitter, people were wondering if Shane would finally come to her defense and end his friendship with Jeffree. That's when people on Twitter noticed Shane and Rylan were no longer following Trisha on Instagram, and she wasn't following them either. At first, I thought maybe Shane didn't even follow Trisha since her Instagram was deleted and she had to create a new account, but he definitely did follow her. Just a few weeks ago now, he congratulated her on her engagement on Instagram and tagged her new account. So this was tea. Everyone was talking about the fact that Shane must have unfollowed Trisha on Instagram, which also meant he was siding with Jeffree. More and more people started talking about Shane and Rylan unfollowing her, but that's actually not what happened at all. Shane and Rylan didn't unfollow me, just to set the record straight. I blocked them. There's no malice behind it. I did it for my own peace. It's not drama. It's very personal, and I want to move on. So speculation can stop as to why they unfollowed. They didn't. Everyone under this tweet seemed so happy for Trisha. As I'm sure a lot of you guys know, it can be super hard to cut off a friend that's turned toxic, especially one that you've known for as long as Trisha has known Shane. The funny but sad thing about the situation is the fact that Shane has known Trisha for so long, literally her entire YouTube career, and he didn't defend her. Yet Ethan and Ela, who've only known Trisha for a short time, jumped to Trisha's defense as soon as they found out about Hair by Jay's livestream. They were on live when it all went down, and you could just tell how mad Ethan was about the words coming out of Jay's mouth. Yet with Shane, it was crickets. After Trisha cleared up the unfollowing stuff on Twitter, she went on to post a YouTube video titled, "I Just Want to Move On." Trisha actually wrote a really long caption underneath the video that said, "I truly don't want any back and forth, because what else needs to be said? Jeffree is right, he did apologize, Hair by Jay apologized, and I just want to move past it. It triggered me then, and it triggers me now. I just wanted to make this video to state that just because I'm moving forward, as I need to continue to make money for myself, doesn't mean I'm over it or moving on. I want to make it very clear that I no longer want any association with Jeffree or Shane. They both made their characters clear to me. I'm not perfect, I never claim to be, but I own up to my wrongs, my faults, and if the triggers I've set off for anyone else unintentionally or otherwise, I apologize. It's even worse when it's done privately behind people you trusted with your feelings and truth. It's all disheartening, and this is the worst loss I've ever felt so far in my life. Everyone thinks I'm a drama queen and I'm always in drama, and that's fine if that's the perception, because I will never stay silent on harassment manipulation, etc. If that makes me less of a person, then oh well. I guess that's just one of my many flaws. I truly send no hate or ill will towards Shane or Jeffree or Jay, and I truly want to keep moving forward. Not only was this video really sad because she's clearly upset, but it was also full of tea about Shane, Jeffree, and Ryland. Trisha starts off the video by saying Jeffree has been going behind closed doors, telling people the reason he sent her home early was because she was on something during the trip. She denies this, and even her sister made a TikTok explaining that she dropped Trisha off for the trip and picked her up early, and she was never on anything. She was just nervous.
I actually dropped her off at the jet in Van Nuys. No, she was not on anything. She was very nervous. And then I picked her up early at LAX because she did not want to be around that those types of people. They were being rude to her. They made fun of the Crocs that she was wearing on the jet, saying like she's just trash or whatever to her face. So that's why she decided to come home early. She cried. I cried because no human being should ever be treated like that. So
finally, Trisha says that she doesn't support Shane Dawson anymore. She says she's been blindly supporting him and truly thought that he did change. Although she does think that he changed from his past that everyone's mad about, she doesn't think that he changed for the better. Apparently, Shane even told her that he's scared of Jeffree too, and he was trying to slowly distance himself from him, yet turned around and praised him on Ryland's podcast and Instagram. She said Shane reached out to her over the weekend and asked her to just come over and postmate food and forget about the whole thing. Now, I don't know about you guys, but to me, that kind of sounded like Shane is just trying to dismiss her feelings and hide from what's going on. Trisha said that Shane told her just yesterday that he wanted to believe the stuff that she told him about Jeffree being mean to her on the trip wasn't true. He said he had to keep standing by Jeffree because he had his back during the cancellation. How can you believe it's not true when your best friend of 12 years is crying to you on the phone for hours about what happened? She goes on to explain that she didn't want Shane to come back and break his silence just to stand up for her. All she wanted from him was to at least unfollow Jay and remove their latest podcast, fangirling over Jeffree. She talks about how Shane is the one who got himself into this friendship because he pretty much redeemed Jeffree. A lot of people on the internet weren't really a fan of Jeffree, and then once Shane came along and did a documentary on him, a lot of people forgave him. He did the same thing with other problematic creators like Tana Mojo and Jake Paul. She thinks maybe Jeffree used Shane to redeem himself, but at the same time, maybe Shane used Jeffree to make millions off of makeup. She says they sold their soul to the devil and sold out. Despite knowing how horrible Jeffree was to Trisha, they continue to hype Jeffree up on Instagram, they continue to clickbait Jeffree on their podcast for views, and they continue to be friends with him. Here's the tea though. Trisha says Shane has been speaking about her behind her back for years. You guys remember the drama that happened between Gabby and Trisha? Apparently, Trisha was told that the person who told Gabby that Trisha had an STD was Shane Dawson. Even a few months ago on the Frenemies podcast, Trisha talked about this and said Gabby is crazy and Shane would never do that.
The only reason I disliked her from the beginning was she like wanted to be my friend. I finally had to tell her, hey, you told my boyfriend I had these when I didn't. She told Jason I had before I even really? Knew her. And then he didn't want to like me for a long time. And then he's like, oh, but Gabby said, I was like, what? And then she said she told David and all these people. I was like, okay, she's weird. So I just kept my distance.
Do you have herpes? You don't have herpes.
I don't have herpes. And I would like, first of all, she wouldn't know. I never was her friend. Then she tried to blame it on like Shane telling her that I had herpes, which that's not true. But she tried to blame him because she's crazy.
In this video, Trisha went into even more detail about all the things Jeffree did to her on the trip. She said he would tell her to come downstairs to the casino in the hotel, and when she would go down, he wouldn't be there and he wouldn't answer the phone. He even told her that his assistant Maddie threw her designer bag in the trash. Trisha did acknowledge Hair by Jay's apology video. He went on live and kind of apologized to Trisha, but honestly to me, it sounded pretty forced. She says any client should think twice before booking an appointment with him. Overall, it just seems like Trisha wants to move on from the situation. She's blocked all of them on her social media, and she doesn't want the reminder of what they said to her or what they did to her. She said Jeffree will always keep winning in life, even though he's mean and nasty. She also revealed that Shane has a huge project coming up, which is like massive tea. Remember two Frenemies episodes ago, she started to reveal that information but quickly stopped herself and everyone was speculating that she was gonna spill some tea about Shane's return? Well, that's exactly what it was. This morning, Jeffree went on Twitter and tweeted about Hair by Jay, and it sounds like he might have fired him. He wrote, "Good morning to everyone except the guy that used to do my hair. I always hold the people around me accountable. I know that's hard for some people to believe, but I'm a grown man and 2021 will only be full of good energy." A lot of people just weren't having this tweet. It sounded as if Jeffree was trying to distance himself from the situation when he actually played a big part in it. Yes, Jay did go on live and say those horrible things, but those things, according to Trisha, were fueled by what Jeffree was saying. Trisha compares Jeffree Star to a cult where the leader makes his followers do all of his dirty work and then distances himself from the act when they get caught. Anyways guys, let me know what you think about everything down below. If you liked the video, hit the thumbs up button because it really does help my channel, and I'll see you next time.